Hey, Dr. C with you. Let's talk about better digestion with butyrate. I almost thought about better belly with butyrate, but that was just over the top. So what the heck is butyrate? Well, we know about digestion, and we know that the gut is the center of the body, you know, literally and figuratively. We know that digestive function is central to overall health. We've had this microbiome revolution that, boy, probably started, maybe the 90s, and it's just losing no steam. We noted that the microbiome is relevant to all facets of health. For a while, we thought the good bacteria were good because they pushed away the bad ones. Now we know that, yeah, but probably a bigger part of why they're good is that they make useful compounds that help our body stay in top-notch shape. Of these useful compounds, one class has garnered a lot of research attention, and those are called short-chain fatty acids. So fats are hydrocarbons. They're these carbon chains with hydrogens wrapped around them and various amounts of bonds. And there's some very short ones that have unique properties. The short-chain fatty acids, of those, probably the best studied is butyrate. This is a 4-carbon fatty acid, and this is found in foods, and the bacteria in our gut synthesize it. That's where pretty much all of it comes from bacterial synthesis, and this is fuel to the colonocytes. So colonocytes, these are the cells that line the whole intestinal tract. And no joke, their main fuel is butyrate. That's what they thrive on. So in the body, butyrate has a couple of really important roles. That's one, it's fuel for those cells. Another one is that it stabilizes the replication of those cells. Now, the cells that line the intestinal tract, they are constantly being regenerated. They're always turning over. You know, old ones get sloughed off, new ones take the position. That's why we see cancers show up in the intestinal lining. So we know that butyrate lowers the risk of those cancers from forming. And the last big role to mention is that butyrate helps regulate the body's immune system. We hear about the immune system being harbored in the intestinal tract. It's true. And the presence of butyrate makes all of that work better. So when butyrate is lacking, the gut becomes more permeable, more inflamed, and the immune system can't really manage itself outside of the intestinal tract. So things that butyrate helps with, there's two relative to digestion that I want to really highlight. First up is this thing called leaky gut, gut permeability, digestive windows, tight junctions. So this is a fascinating concept. We know that the gut is kind of like a screen door. It's got little gaps that let some things in and keep other things out. You know, your screen door should let in fresh air, but it should keep out the mosquitoes. So in the gut, ideally, the screen lets in vital nutrients, but keeps out large undigested protein and infectious material. Now, the simplified model that's kind of made the rounds in natural medicine is that bad things break the screen open, bad things get in, and disease sets in. And so the thought is that leaky gut causes disease. The new views are getting a lot more nuanced than that. What we're realizing is that leaky gut is associated with disease, but it may not cause disease. What I mean by that is if you take a look at people that have diabetes, autoimmunity, arthritis, lupus, you name it, they likely have more permeability than other groups would. But the question is whether that permeability is helpful or just kind of a random thing that shows up with the illness. The data's gotten strong that it's not the cause of illness. We know that for several different lines of inquiry, but the new thought is what parts of immune dysregulation cause leaky gut. And it's not that we need to reverse the leaky gut directly, we need to reverse the underlying things that give rise to leaky gut. So this is kind of a nuance, but butyrate doesn't so much put plaster on a cracked wall, but it more so regulates the immune system in ways where the gut stops becoming too permeable. The body quits doing it by itself. So there's nothing more direct than butyrate for helping to reverse the whole process of intestinal permeability. Now, related to that is irritable bowel syndrome and inflammatory bowel disease. These things are the main sources of chronic digestive problems. And we know that they are given rise to from poor neurologic signaling in the case of IBS, or chronic inflammatory responses in the case of inflammatory bowel diseases. And butyrate makes a big difference on both ends. It can help heal up the nerve junctions that are part of the proper neurologic signaling, and it simply regulates the overall inflammatory load that's a big part of an inflammatory bowel disease. So those that have ulcerative colitis or Crohn's disease, they've been shown to improve when the amount of butyrate in their intestinal tract can pick up. Other things that can help with, boy, you name it almost. And this is because digestion is so central to overall health. We know that it can lower the risk of colorectal cancer. It can improve sleep. It can help many neurologic issues. It can benefit weight loss. It can offset insulin resistance. It can regulate appetite. So all these are benefits that we know occur from having more butyrate in the intestinal tract. So where do you get butyrate from? Well, one thing I hear a lot, I see many talk about butter being a source of butyrate. It is. Yeah, the names, there's no coincidence the names are so darn similar. Butter has butyric acid. The problem is that the butyrate in our colon is more so what's made there, not what comes in there. And just that's because what comes in is so, I don't know, it's used differently in the upper intestinal tract than it is in the lower intestinal tract. And then also because food sources like butter don't have all that much. We think it takes somewhere around 8,000 milligrams of butyrate a few times a day to make a big difference in improving digestion. So if you want that from butter, we're talking about 2 or 3 sticks of butter per day. No kidding, sticks of butter. And I can't even imagine how badly that would bother your digestive function, not because of the butyrate, just because all that fat you're consuming, all that saturated fat, that would be, yeah, just not a good idea. There are supplements that contain butyrate too, but their data, there's not strong, consistent data about their benefit. And this is also because most of their effects are taking place in the upper intestinal tract and because they smell god-awful and they really irritate the intestines from most people. So not quite effective that way. But the body makes them by metabolizing indigestible portions of carbohydrate. And the biggest factor that way is resistant starch. You guys may have heard me talk about resistant starch before. This is one of the exciting things about it. It's where your body gets butyrate is from resistant starch. Now, here's the story. Carbohydrate is absorbed in the small intestine. Resistant starch is not. That's the resistant part. It resists digestion and is not absorbed in the small intestine. Once it gets into the colon, however, it's this ultimate food for your good bacteria. They eat this up like crazy, and in turn, they make resistant starch. I'm sorry, they make butyrate and short chain fats out of it. So the more you can elevate your resistant starch intake, that's the way you really leverage your overall butyrate content. And you can do this in a couple of ways. I would really encourage focusing on dietary sources of resistant starch. Many like to supplement with it, and I'll talk about that. But dietary sources are good because they come in the context of a variety of different kinds of fibers. Fibers are a category, they're not a thing, and you want a big variety of them for resistant starch to work better. Some of my favorites, potatoes, white beans, bananas, plantains, those couple of foods are far, far and away the highest sources of resistant starch. You'll find it in countless other food sources, but the amounts become much less relevant. Those are the big superstars. You know, think about doing one of those each day, and you'll probably make a big difference over time. There are those that do want to jumpstart, and there's those that have a hard time with those foods for various reasons. You know, maybe they're AIP, maybe they're low carb, maybe they've got certain allergens they're avoiding. That's all valid. In those cases, I've made a purified blend called RS Complete. So it's free of the allergens, the lectins, the nightshade compounds, and it also has verified amounts of resistant starch. Many have said, hey, look, I went and bought some unmodified potato flour. I bought some green banana flour. Didn't seem to help. So I'm not sure about this resistant starch thing. Well, when you buy those products, they don't have any standardization. And that's why it took me so dang long to make this mixture, because a lot of the raw materials I was trying to get for it didn't have what I needed. They didn't have active amounts in them. And I was really shocked about that. So focus on foods first and foremost. If that's difficult for you, consider RS Complete as an easy way to get a whopping dose in a small flavorless scoop. But RS is a powerful way to raise butyrate, and butyrate can give you a better belly and better digestive function, lower risk for colorectal cancer, easier time with weight loss, better blood sugar regulation, better health overall through better digestion. All right, Dr. C with you. Take care, We'll check in really soon. Bye-bye.